A very good evening to one and all, and we are back with the third episode of ABC of Parenting. And today we are going to talk about another very important aspect of parenting, that is how to set up two-way communication with your teenagers. Because आजकल की दुनिया में हमें पता है कि इतनी सारी सोशल मीडिया चीजें हैं, इतनी सारी यू नो चिल्ड्रन आर बम्बार्डेड विद सो मच ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, तो उनके साथ कम्युनिकेशन कैसे सेटअप करनी है एंड हाउ एग्जैक्टली पेरेंट्स कैन टेक टाइनी स्टेप्स टू क्रिएट दैट कॉन्फिडेंस अमंग द किड दैट दे कैन वॉक टू द पेरेंट्स एंड टॉक इजीली. एंड वी ऑल्सो नो दैट एडोलेसेंस इज अ वेरी वाइल्ड एज. Where children tend to do a lot of mistakes, where children tend to do a lot of exploration, and not just in the house or just in the school, but outside that also. And social media adds another bit to it that they do more these days. And we have a very special guest, Miss Kavita Lata. She's a principal educationist and a wonderful mother of one girl. And I would request Miss Kavita Lata to join us, and she will set the context about today's topic, is how to set up two-way communication with our teenagers.
Thank you, Ms. Pragati. That's a wonderful introduction about me. I never knew all these things are relating me. Please, the topic what you chose today is very, very interesting topic, the two-way communication with the teenagers. The vibe itself in the teenagers, so even we, when we pronounce, we think of our teenage and all the things. So it's a very, very, very vibrant age in one's own life. Time is teenage, and the wonderful genius or the most genius is born out from the teenage. Teenage is always taken only from 12 to 18 or 19 in most of the social knowledge. But generally, adolescents, when we talk about adolescents, we divide it into three classes: early adolescence, middle adolescence, and late adolescence. Early adolescence is the age like 10 to 12, and middle adolescence from 12 to, we'll take 17, and from 17 to young adults, we call 21, we call them as late adolescence. So as a parent, first we should know into which stage of adolescence is our child falling. And next, we should understand the general growth and development process in each stage of adolescence. See, in early adolescence, that is from childhood, they are coming to the adolescent age or the sweet teenage. So in that age, first thing what everybody undergoes, the transition majorly, what we see is the physical and mental developments, emotional development. Physical is the first thing, especially both male and female. It is the age of attaining puberty. So lot much of physical development happens in every individual. And so attainment of puberty is something which is new to a teenager, and that really pushes them into lot many fears, confusion, anxiety, and sometimes depression also. So in that age, if we are handling a kid of that age, definitely we should be with them. We should transform them, and we should transmit our knowledge, sharing our knowledge. We should help them to understand they are quite natural changes which happen to all of us. That is the physical changes, the secondary sexual characteristic developments. And when coming to the emotional development, because of the hormonal changes, especially the adrenaline and all, the aggressiveness or sort of adamance, or sometimes parents quite common, often they complain that all these years they were listening to us, now suddenly this change has taken place that they are not listening to us anymore, all this quite common reason. So when we take the middle adolescence, this is age where the thrive for independence or the goal for independence is little more, self-esteem is expected little high, and they start having a complete abstract thinking is not possible, but they start from concrete thinking. They'll be visualizing their goals, and exactly that is the age where they go for the long-term goals. See, sometimes children are very dedicated in their picks. They want to become a musician, they want to become a fine art, they want to become an engineer, they want to become, so they will have, that means somewhere some spark, that hero worship develops in this age. So might be they come across some famous personality, some celebrity in the social media, or somebody in the family, or some inspiring stories from the teacher. So some character would have appealed them so very much, so they will think that, okay, in my life I'm going to be this. So that is how children fix their aims, and that is the reason we call that a true genius is born from adolescence. Sometimes that will be very, very rigidly fixed in the mind, subconscious mind of an adolescent child. And if we can identify such things in the right age, even we can give the assistance as parents, what additional skills are required for their goals to be realized, what additional support is required, so we can also identify the interests and get along with them. And in this age, little fluctuations are there. So as we see the infatuations or the escaping from parents, excessive defensive mechanism, peer loyalties, so all this, maybe they want more of healthier independence, not parents involving in much into their efforts. All these they will be expecting us to do. Obviously, parents do know how to track our own child's activities. More or less, we will be with them. And late adolescence is something, the young adulthood we call. They are clear more with the moral thinking, discrimination, right and wrong, and very much about strong about their thought process. A sort of affirmed nature is observed. So these are the physical and mental changes or the emotional developments. So early childhood adolescent would be more strict, less balanced, aggressive. So physical growth will be more. But when it comes for the middle adolescence, physical growth is almost less. It is very less, especially in female. In males, it will take to a certain extent. And when they reach the adulthood, almost the stabilization of the growths will be there. So this is the basic classification, what we understand and need to. Sometimes unknowingly, it is we lead them into confusion. Already adolescent is called as nobody understands me age. The most beautiful age, it is called nobody understands me age, because they have lot many things. They want a listening partner. They want to express. They are already well-formed emotional aptitudes and attitudes are with them. They want somebody to pay attention to them. So when they don't have a proper outlet, proper channel to express themselves, they feel restless. And sometimes we are busy with our own schedules and may not give quality time. And such times children often complain that nobody understands me. And sometimes this is one major factor. They want to be lonely or aloof, using more of social media. If you take the data today, 92% of teenagers are into social media, and whereas 24% are constantly into social media usage. So that is how the reports speak high about it. When they are totally engrossed with the family routines, not having a separate routine for them, which is exclusively majorly social media and minorly family activities, or real-time relationships should be actively maintained. And empathy, above everything, empathy. We are grown up, we have seen, so we can't simply rule out everything that is, it should have not happened. You should have not been so. Why can't he be so? There is no wrong response in this universe, but always there is a better way to express, there is a better way to react, or there is a better way to respond, but there is no wrong way, because to his knowledge. When that is happening, let us explain how to read instead blaming why did that happen. Why did you do is not right. How to do it is the right approach. So these are the simple things in a nutshell I would like to inform all the parents. When you have certain problems, consistently try this, then we can definitely see some change. But lot of patience is required. Handling an adolescent child is really a skill, a science, and an art above everything.
Whenever I ask my child about the day or something, he gives a very basic answers like yes, no, or just one line. he doesn't enjoy conversing with me, as we don't know the cool lingo, social media lingo, and how can we set up a fun conversation with my teenager?
Yes, so a very, very, very realistic question, Ms. Pragati. And most of the parents are depressed with this, you know. What is wrong? Where are we wrong? Where is it going wrong? I have set up everything. We are doing everything what my child needs. But still, they are aloof. They are pushing us away from their space. They are getting attracted towards their peers, or they don't want to share everything. This is really a bothering question in many of the parent minds. I really feel that this is a very, very apt question, because it's a very true. Here, I would like to tell two things to all the parents who are undergoing such, or more or less, every parent has this situation sometime or the other. For this, one thing what I suggest is, we should definitely have the routines fixed in every family based on our working conditions, along with the adolescent routine set. When you have this routine set in the family, our family time or the me time and the child's family time, what you are giving, should collide, so that we will have constantly some time spending with them. Not weekly, once or twice when we have mood, calling them, chalo beta, now you tell me what has happened today in the school. The child gives either, yeah, okay, that's okay, that was a nice day, yeah, everything well, or they shrug the shoulders, or they sometimes show this, some, no, not so fine.
Yes.
I mean, these 4-5 short answers, crisp answers, you see. But that really pricks us a lot. Why is this kid, earlier he used to tell, right from he boarded the bus till he comes home, till he says bye to his teacher, lot many volumes going around, mama in the kitchen, not allowing father to do something, they'll be going around us behind and telling all this. Now what is the reason? One is, as I was mentioning, the changes which are coming in them always make them to use some privacy and independence. So they feel that they are grown up, they don't need to share, they are big enough to enjoy themselves or bear the problems themselves. But it is really dangerous, because sometimes this is the age where bullying or some sort of peer pressure, when peers start criticizing or commenting, they will not express, and they start feeling inferior towards themselves. And when such things are there, you should not only observe their answers, you should even observe their other physical routines also. Are they sleeping on the time, that is sleep and wake up patterns, food, are they skipping the meals or trying to avoid all of you, or are they always interested to sit alone, go into their own room, or not coming out much? All these factors also we need to check. If everything is okay except for this, then our part as a parent would be, one is routine setting. It will not happen overnight, as I told. All these will take minimum 1 to 2 months if you start practicing. Make the adolescent feel more comfortable, and you should not start talking with a formal introduction, which always, like, it's a block, roadblock or a mind block, where they will not open up for sure. Chalo, now you finished dinner, now we are going to talk about your next coming examinations and your preparations, how you are going to do.
You have your unit of the millennium, I guess, talking about exam is the most boring talk children find.
Yeah, not only boring, that pre-introductions are not to be given many times, ma'am. So should be very quite informal talking. So what I have seen you today, not much energetic today. Every day you are taking part in helping mama or doing your things by now. So some eye questions I have noticed. I have been observing. I have seen you. So when you start relating, you know, sometimes even in my school days, I had today I had a problem issue with my friend, and that friend was very close to me, but today we had some small issue, and really I was apologizing, but the friend didn't come to me, something. So we should always relate ourselves to that. So this is quite common with you, and that is how things happen. All are not always happy, but you know, I was also having, like that, when we relate to our own life and share the experiences, that builds confidence.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And I guess one more point which I want to add is that what I have felt is I've always in my teens, my mother will come back from work and whenever she had a bad day, she would definitely tell us that I had a bad day. And she would share things with me so that it feels like, okay, I am also as important or, you know, as like her own, very convenient talking to her. It was very convenient talking, but she was very, very smart, I would say, that time to convey that only some part of it she will convey, but she will definitely make me feel very comfortable that mama also shares a lot of things with you. So it becomes a two-way communication. Then we children feel that, okay, our mothers also share her, you know, stories and problems.
Like a venting partner.
Yes. So they are like the conversing partners. It's a conversation.